Hello, my name is Yoji Sekine from Keysight Technologies, and today I'd like to introduce some of the challenges facing USB 3.1 10 gigabit cable measurement. What I have here today is our E5071C ENA network analyzer with our TDR option. Connected to the network analyzer is a prototype Type-C cable. Due to the higher data rates, at 10 gigabit, one unit interval is 100 picoseconds. And that leads to tighter device margins, and therefore there's a increasing need to remove the effects of the test fixtures for measurements to get correct results. What I have shown here is the insertion loss measurement of the prototype Type-C cable. This measurement is done without any correction, and this red line is the test limit for USB Type-C, and this cable is failing. The calibration reference plane is at the front of the test equipment, and by calibrating to the end of the test fixtures, we can improve the measurement by removing the effects of the test cables. It improved the insertion loss a little bit, but the loss of the fixtures are still included in the measurement. So what we want to do there is apply some de-embedding. To remove the effects of the fixture, extend the calibration reference plane to the end of the fixtures and measure the true performance of the device. Another challenge facing USB 3.1 is that the traditional method of characterization has its limitations. The traditional method consisted of measuring the impedance in time domain, insertion loss, return loss in the frequency domain. The limitation of this method is that it doesn't allow for trade-offs between the different parameters. Let's say, for example, you had sufficient margin in the insertion loss and you were failing several points on the return loss trace. When you connected this cable to the system, it could very well be that the cable would work without any issues, but according to the specification, this is a bad cable because it failed that return loss test. To ensure sufficient yield at the higher data rates, new compliance test methodology is being implemented for USB 3.1. And that's called stress side diagram analysis. So what we do here is, rather than measuring the individual time domain and frequency domain response, we're going to characterize the cable using eye diagrams. So rather than breaking it down into individual components, we can characterize the cable and do pass-fail testing on the overall response. That allows for trade-offs between the different parameters. For USB 3.1, their implementation of stress side diagram testing is based on the channel metrics, and the USBIF will provide a tool which does the calculations of the eye diagrams based on the S parameters inputted into the tool. The third challenge is an issue we've encountered with USB 3.0. There were issues reported for RF interference, and there has been modifications done to the USB 3.1 connector to ensure sufficient grounding, as well as additions to the test specification to ensure that RF interference is mitigated correctly. We've seen some of the challenges facing the USB 3.1 10 gigabit data rate cable measurement. If you are interested in further details on our solution, please visit our website. Thanks for watching.